This video is sponsored by Amazon Fire TV.
What's going on, guys? It's your average consumer. And finally, we are gonna be checking out something I've been working on for a long time, the man cave. So let's take a look. So right here is our entrance to the man cave. And if you can't tell, there's gonna be a lot of Gundam love in here. But I gotta show you guys what it's all about. So in typical UAC fashion, Alexa, start the man cave. So guys, we are finally here in the man cave. It is, for now, what I'd call complete. There's a lot of stuff here, but the overall aesthetic for what I was trying to go for was like a clean, modern, chill kind of vibe. So we got a lot of, you know, blacks and grays, and you know, we have the hint of the warm colors, the orange in the lamps and whatnot. But we gotta talk about the tech that's inside of here. So let's head on over to this section, which is pretty much where we've got our TV and our consoles. So what we've got right here, guys, is an LG 65-inch OLED TV. This thing is absolutely amazing. The picture quality and everything, it's awesome. It's an OLED TV. Not only do we have that, but most importantly is this guy right here, the Fire TV Cube. It's a second generation streaming media player that hosts all of my favorite streaming apps. And this thing is an absolute must have for me because of all of the awesome voice controls. Amazon was cool enough to send this thing out for me before it came out so we could hook up the cave. And guys, let me tell you, it is awesome. Now, I absolutely love this thing because I can control almost every aspect of the TV. I can have it switch inputs like Alexa, switch to HDMI 3. Nothing's on it right now, so it's gonna say no signal. And that's cool because if I'm playing a game and I wanna switch to a show or something, I don't need to look for a remote.
I just talk to the Fire TV Cube.
And it does what I need it to. Now, not only can I control what input the TV is on, the volume, that kind of stuff, but I could pull up shows too. So I could say, Alexa, watch Demon Slayer on Hulu. Now it's gonna automatically switch to Demon Slayer on Hulu, and that's without me touching a remote. Boom. Now that is absolutely cool because it can search through the different streaming apps. You just pretty much call out the title you want to watch and you got it playing. And it's what controlled all of the smart home stuff that you saw come on just now. So all the smart plugs, smart lights, the Philips Hue in the back of the TV, all that got turned on from all the way over here. And I was down at the entrance of the man cave. Not to mention, guys, it has Crunchyroll right here. This is an app that you guys know me. I love this because I can watch my anime. None of the smart TVs that I use has this app. So this thing is a major, major win for me.
The Fire TV Cube is something you gotta give a shot.
If you guys know me, you know I love voice controls, and this thing kind of puts the whole setup together as you saw.
So be sure to check it out in the links down below in the description.
But around that, we also have a couple of speakers. We've got the play bar, and we've got the two surrounds on the sides and a couple in the back behind the sofa that we have over here. But what's important over here in this section, not only is it the TV and the audio, but the things that we're actually using. So we of course have every system down here is actually the PlayStation 4 Pro 500 million edition. That thing looks absolutely gorgeous, perfect for this place. It's blue, but it's got those nice warm accents just like this room has, so it fits really well. And speaking of, when we're playing, the gaming headset that I like to use a lot these days are the Astro A40s. These are the tournament edition, the wired version. This thing is just absolutely amazing. I really, really love Astro's headsets. They do just a phenomenal job for me. The audio quality, the mic quality, it's just a really good look. And you even have controls here on the side. It's a nice setup. You can use this on the PC as well. And for our Xbox One X, we've got the Gears of War 5 edition. That thing is one of the best looking Xboxes ever created. I absolutely love it. And we've got a Nintendo Switch as well. We got it in the dock. So we got that guy. Now you might've noticed Now I have these stands over here. These stands are amazing. Basically, if you have anything that you want to put on display, like this beautiful, beautiful Gundam 007 sword over here, you guys know me. You knew I was going to talk about my Gundams. But I have two of my biggest versions over here. This is a perfect grade. I know I'm getting really nerdy and technical here, but my boy Jared hooked this up, so I had to put this on display. I built my own. You guys gotta see, I put a lot of effort into this, so you guys gotta at least take a look at it, okay? I don't care who doesn't care about it. And you know, I do this thing as a hobby. I put them together. Sometimes I have my boy put it together so that I can have like a special custom design, because I don't paint, but I do snap them together. I cut out the parts, and I actually have a section for that right over here. This is my Gundam building area. So I've got a whole desk dedicated to this. It's off to the side, so it's not in the way when you come in here. You don't see that there's this whole Gundam shrine or workshop over here. But when I'm ready to just like relax, chill a little bit, take my mind off of work and everything, I could just come down here and then I start snapping away. I just take out my pieces, start putting them together, and then I end up with a figure that looks like these guys. For my Gundam builders out there who I know watch the channel, this is actually a pretty cool thing to pick up. This is a runner holder. As you guys can see, there are lots of parts. So if you wanna keep them organized, you can just have something like that. Also, we last Gundam bit. You guys see that we've got the Gundam artwork. We've got the Wing Zero custom over here. We got his arch nemesis, Epion, down there. And we even have Banshee on this side. Right above this Banshee, actually, we have these Nanoleaf canvas. And you can actually interact with this, which is kind of cool. So I can change the scenes, swap the colors. Aside from that, let's see. I don't know if you guys are interested in some of the furniture that I got here. But these lamps I got from, I don't even really remember, but I'll have it linked down below in the description if you guys wanna check it out. Other furniture we got here that's awesome. You guys see this sofa set that we've got here. This is actually from a company called Article. Absolutely amazing furniture here. Super comfortable. The material is great. I needed something that had a very specific look, and Article actually had it. They've got a lot of good looking furniture, and it's actually pretty affordable. This chair would have been extremely expensive at some of the places that I've seen it, and it was actually a really good price article. So if you guys are interested in checking out some good looking furniture, I'll have a link down below in the description. I actually bought myself another set of these for the studio because I love it so much. So definitely check out Article, great stuff, awesome materials, and honestly, check it out. It fits with the room very well. This coffee table right here, you've seen it before. If you've seen the Gamer's Paradise, you've seen this thing. This is the Sobro. It's a coffee table with a built-in fridge, a built-in Bluetooth speaker, built-in LED lights that you can't see right now because it's on a carpet. And we even got some PlayStation coasters over here. But most importantly, I know you see what's back there. You see that desk. And we're gonna talk about that right now. So what we've got right here is an extremely large desk that I have not completely, I guess, furnished. We got a lot of empty space over here. If I want to do some work on some paper, maybe, I don't know. Give me some ideas, guys. What do I put over here? We have our computer. You guys know Leek. Leek is the first PC that I ever built completely by myself. Let me tell you, this is a behemoth. It's called Leek because there's a couple things I wanna change and fix in there, but it's actually a Typhoon. It's powering these two Acer Predator X34s. These are a little bit dated now, but I also pulled them from the last Gamer's Paradise. I'm probably gonna have something even better in the Gamer's Paradise, but for down here at home, this is more than enough. We've got a dual monitor setup. Both of them are wall mounted, so we can keep the cables nice and clean. You guys can see that cable management is absolutely dope. You guys have seen me talk about the SteelSeries keyboard before. This is the SteelSeries Apex 7 mechanical keyboard. I honestly love this thing. It feels very comfortable to type on. It's got the RGB lights, of course, so that you can go ahead and customize it if you've got like a certain look to go with. And one thing I really love is the fact that it's got a little OLED screen over here. Obviously, got a little Gundam face on there. And the mouse that I use is the Logitech G502 wireless. We also have like this giant SteelSeries mouse pad. This is kind of cool because it has the RGB lights all around it. Looks awesome. And as for the speakers we got over here, these are the Logitech G560s. They're pretty cool. They got RGB lights in there as well. Now, I didn't want to go too crazy with the RGB lights. I feel like this isn't too bad. Obviously, it's lit up, but I feel like it's still a pretty clean aesthetic over here. We got the background to match on the monitors. We got my boy Gogeta over here. This guy's over here looking dope and amazing. Shout out to all the other Dragon Ball Z figures you guys might have seen at the other end of the room and whatnot. In terms of audio stuff, we're rocking. These are the Sennheiser GSP-670. Now, these are actually good for the PlayStation 4 and the PC, but I primarily use them on the PC. I absolutely love these things. They feel extremely, extremely comfortable. They've got a great mic. And we also got a couple of other little accessories on the desk. We've got the Elgato Stream Deck. You guys know about this. You press a button, you can make all kinds of applications open up. We've also got the Wu Audio WA7 Fireflies. That is a dope amplifier. I got a specific pair of Sennheiser headphones that I really wanna try out with this so I can get the full quality out of it. Haven't gotten them yet, but I have this guy waiting here in preparation. And we got a wireless charger for my phones with wireless charging, could charge up the Apple Watch over here. And we also got this really cool clock over here. I got this in a massive tech unboxing. It honestly just fits so perfectly for the in this room that I had to bring it over. And we got that lamp from IKEA. It's got like a speaker in it. And the gaming chair that I have right here, this is actually from the folks over at Main Gear. They were cool enough to send this out. And let me tell you guys, this thing is comfortable. It is an extremely comfortable chair. You got that back support with this little padding over here. It makes gaming on this or sitting at the computer for a long time a breeze. But something else I want to talk about real quick is the kind of desk setup that we've got over here. Now, most of you probably already know you can use IKEA countertops as a desktop, but I will warn you guys, these long kitchen countertops, they tend to bow a little bit, so they'll kind of sink in the middle depending on what you have, especially if you have like a computer and monitor sitting right in the center. So I had to go ahead and get like these little legs drilled into them to give it some extra support. But that is pretty much it for this part of the man cave. We got the computer area where we can do, you know, work or game on a PC. We've also got the TV area where we can game, watch television shows, that kind of thing. But I gotta show you guys what's on this side of the man cave. But before we do that, check this out, guys. This is the smartest light switch you will ever see. This is actually from Brilliant Home. So as you guys can see, it just looks like a picture frame of some sort, but this is actually a light switch. I can control my lights just by swiping up and down. So not only can you control the lights, so I have just regular recessed lights up here, just dimmable lights, and I can actually make them into smart lights with this light switch. I can go ahead and control the lights and dim them with the screen. Something else that's really cool with this is that you guys can see right here, it's got a little camera up top. Now we have this in other parts of the house, and it works as a video intercom system. And I can even answer the door from here. So we've got our Ring doorbell and August lock all hooked up. Coolest light switch you will ever see. But moving on, this right here, guys, is the ultimate home theater. This has been a major, major process. But if you wanna see everything, you guys can check all of this out in the video down below. But yeah, guys, this is it. This is the man cave. This took forever to put together, but I feel like it's in a place where I really feel comfortable showing it to you guys. Hopefully you guys get a little bit of inspiration on what you can do with certain setups to make them a little bit cleaner. But hopefully you enjoyed this video. This was a long time in the making. Whoever wants to come over and hang out, hit me up. You're all welcome. But till the next video, guys, it's your average consumer. Peace.